कम लेट्स गो विद बाइपोलर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन. दिस सर्क्यूट डायग्राम रिप्रेजेंट बाइपोलर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन सर्क्यूट डायग्राम. ए बाइपोल इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू पोल्स इन सच ए वे दैट अ कॉमन लो वोल्टेज रिटर्न पाथ इफ अवेलेबल will only carry a small unbalanced current during normal operation. Look at this diagram. This configuration is used if the required transmission capacity exceeds that of a single pole. It is so used if requirement to high energy availability or lower load rejection power intakes it necessary to split the capacity on two poles. During maintenance or outage of one pole, it is still possible to transmit part of the power. More than 50% of the transmission capacity can be utilized, limited by the actual overload capacity of the remaining pole. The advantages of a bipolar solution over a solution with two monopoles are reduced cost due to one common or one return path and lower losses. The main disadvantage is that unavailability of the return path with adjacent components will affect both poles. This bipolar long distance transmission having some sub classifications. One is bipole with a ground return path. Second is bipole with dedicated metallic return path for monopolar operation. Third one is bipole without dedicated return path for monopolar operation. First one, bipole with ground return path. This diagram meant by that type. This is a commonly used configuration for a bipolar transmission system. The solution provides a high degree of flexibility. Again, I have to say high degree of flexibility with respect to operation with reduced capacity during contingency or maintenance. The current of the sound pole will be taken over by the ground return path and the faulty pole will be isolated. Second thing is bipole with a dedicated metallic return path for monopolar operation. If there are restrictions, even a temporary use of electrodes, or if the transmission distance is relatively short, a dedicated LVDC metallic return conductor can be considered as an alternative to a ground return path with electrodes. Third thing is a bipole without dedicated return path for monopolar operation. That circuit explanation having a scheme without electrodes or a dedicated metallic return path for monopolar operation will give the lowest initial cost. That means monopolar operation is possible by means of bypass switches during a converter pole outage, but not during an HVDC conductor outage. A short bipolar outage will follow a converter pole outage before the bypass operation can be established. The final one is monopolar metallic return operation. You have to look this diagram upon the comparison of before I taught to you. The monopolar operation always possible by means of bypass switches during a converter pole outage, but not during an HVDC conductor outage. Okay, then monopole metallic return. This monopole metallic return, very specific contingency of this circuit, because two thyristors are excluded of transmission path and two thyristor were included of that transmission path. So it is special case to occur for specifically transmit the transmission. Okay, fine. Okay, in this link of monopolar metallic return operation and bipolar return operation having current flows through the wall when the voltage between the anode and the cathode is positive. For the wall to commutate the current, there must be a positive potential voltage and the thyristor must have firing pulses. In the reverse direction, when the potential between anode and cathode is negative, a firing pulse has no effect. The flow of current in the valve end when the voltage between anode and cathode becomes negative. The instant when current being to flow through a valve are to commutate from one valve to another can be delayed by postponing on the firing. This method permits the average valve of the outgoing voltage of the rectifier to be changed according their representation. Then the firing is exactly. Then the firing pulse has no effect. Because of the cathode is negative, so the flow of current in a valve end when the voltage between anode and cathode becomes negative. The instant when current being to flow through a valve or to commutate from one valve to another can be delayed by postponing the firing. This method permits the average valve of the outgoing voltage of the rectifier to be changed. The firing pulses are generated by synchronizing the network using an electronic control device. That's called ACR, some other advanced power semiconductor switches. It has been natural firing point, which is the point where the two phase voltage intersect. This method of firing pulse displacement is called phase control. The angle between the time at which valve voltage becomes positive and the firing time, that firing time in the sense start of communication, is referred to as the firing delay. That the firing angle of 90 degree, the average voltage equals zero, the positive and negative area of the curve voltage against time, it cancel each other out. There is no active power flows through the converter because we had been inserted across the converter section. Smoothing reactor, so here no active power flows through the converter. When the firing delay is greater than 90 degree, the negative voltage or time areas dominate and the polarity of the average direct voltage changes. Due to this physical reason, the direction of the current does not change. That means the thyristor valve conduct current only in one direction. When the direction energy flows is reversed, the delivery changes to the supply side. The rectifier becomes an inverter which delivering energy to the AC network. Then the average value of the direct voltage as a function of the firing delay is given of mode of operation. Then I'm saying 12 pulse group and converter transform also. That 12 pulse group and in that group HVDC converter are usually built as 12 pulse circuit. Yes, 12 pulse circuit This is a serial connection of two fully controlled 6-pulse converter bridge and requires two 3-phase systems which are spaced apart from each other by 30 electrical degrees. The phase difference is affected to cancel out the 6-pulse harmonics on the AC and DC side. So these are the combination of conversion usually to used in HVDC converter session. So then we must know the reactive power as a function of load. The curve of reactive power demand of HVDC station with the changing active power can be calculated from any kind of mathematical equations. That reactive power demand of a converter is presented under three different control methods. That control methods are terminal DC voltage and the firing angle alpha and gamma of an inverter will be obtained according their various stages. Those three rectifier categories, very important categories, so we similarly obtain that category in order to various session level. Okay.